الحمد لله أحمده وأستعينه وأستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن نبينا محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم تسليما. All praise be to Allah. I praise Him alone. I seek forgiveness from Him. He who Allah guides Him, no one can lead astray. And He who Allah leads astray, no one can guide. I testify that there is no one worthy of being worshipped but Allah, and that Muhammad is the slave and messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in His book, ordering His messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قل Say, O Muhammad, إنما أنا بشر مثلكم. Say, O Muhammad, I am only a human like you. يوحى إلي. But I receive revelation from Allah. أنما إلهكم إله واحد. It has been revealed to me that the one who deserves worship is only one God. فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا. So, he who wishes to meet with his Lord on the day of judgment, while his Lord is pleased with him, then let him do righteous and not associate any partner with God in worship. This is very clear that righteous actions, truthfulness, decency, honesty, doing good to the people, all those good actions are counted, but with one condition, that you do not associate any partner with Allah in worship. For if you do, you gain nothing in the hereafter. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said clearly in His book, وَقَدِمْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا مِنْ عَمَلٍ فَجَعَلْنَاهُ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. On the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will treat the actions of those who did not worship Allah alone, those who associated partners with Allah in worship, He will treat their actions as they don't exist altogether. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam clarified this as narrated in Sahih al-Bukhari. Aisha, the wife of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the most beloved woman and wife of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the most truthful amongst this nation, like her father, may Allah be pleased with them. Aisha radiallahu anha said, I asked the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I said, O Messenger of Allah, there was a person whose name was Abdullah ibn Jud'an before Islam, or he did not become a Muslim while the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was calling them to Islam. But he had so many good deeds. He used to give refuge to those who need. He used to be so generous, opening his door for the poor and needy to come and get what they want and eat what they want. And he used to do this and this and this and this, and she listed so many good actions for him. Then she said, O Messenger of Allah, is any of that going to be beneficial for him in the Day of Judgment? The Prophet ﷺ said, no, none of that. Because he never said, O Allah, forgive me. Because he was associating partners with Allah in his supplication. He was not supplicating to Allah alone. This is the outcome of shirk, associating partners with Allah. This is the danger, that it will cancel all the deeds, all the good deeds. Whatever good you have done will be wiped out, will be worthless if you don't die as a Muslim. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. O you who have faith, be aware of Allah as you should be, as you should be, and do not die except as Muslims, meaning as people who worship Allah alone and do not associate any partner with Allah in worship. And this is Islam. If someone says, I am a Muslim, and he says by his tongue, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, while he supplicates to the dead people, calling them for his needs, he is not a Muslim. He has not said la ilaha illallah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in his book, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَن يَشَاءُ. Allah does not forgive associating partners with him in worship, and he forgives what is less than that, meaning the sins, for those whom he wills. For those whom he wills. Not every sinner will be forgiven for all his sins. No, this is not true. This is not true. Even though there are deviants nowadays, so-called scholars, but they are deviants who put the people under the illusion that if they are Muslims, then no matter what they do, then Allah will forgive them in the Day of Judgment and will take them to paradise. This is not true. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned in many, many true hadiths in Bukhari and Muslim that people will be taken to hellfire, then they will be taken out of it. Who are they? They are not cross worshippers. They are not idol worshippers. They are Muslims who have done sins. They are the ones who will be taken out of hellfire. No one else would be taken out of hellfire but a Muslim. So therefore, my dear brothers, one should realize the danger of shirk, the danger of associating partners with Allah in worship, especially when we know that there are so many things which fall under shirk, as narrated in a hadith that riba yujari is 73 branches and shirk is as much branches, 73 branches, meaning a lot of branches, a lot of statements that you say are shirk, a lot of actions that you do are shirk, a lot of beliefs that you believe are shirk. People swear by other than Allah, people swear by the Prophet, people swear by the Kaaba, people swear by their souls, people swear by their heads, people swear by their children's heads. This is shirk. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man halafa bighayri Allah faqad ashrak." He who swears by other than Allah, he has committed shirk. It is a form of shirk. It is not the great shirk which will take you out of Islam, because it's not a worship. But it is a form of shirk. And any form of shirk is a greater sin than the rest of the sins. That's why it's called shirk. Any sin which is called shirk or kufr, then even if it is small, doesn't take you out of Islam, but it is uglier than the regular sins, which are not called shirk and which are not called kufr. Therefore, my dear brothers, one has to learn what are those things which are shirk. He might be doing them and he doesn't know. And the fact that you do them and you do not know will not save you. When you can learn, and when you know that learning is an obligation, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, طلب العلم فريضة على كل مسلم. Seeking the knowledge is an obligation on every Muslim, male and female, no difference. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially regarding tawheed, regarding this fact of worshipping Him alone and not falling into shirk, He said, فَاعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. You must know that there is no one worthy of being worshipped but Allah. So seeking the knowledge of La ilaha illallah is a priority. You not only learn what is tawheed and what is shirk, but you should learn the proofs from Quran and Sunnah. Learn them so that you become sure that what you are doing is tawheed and what you are avoiding is shirk. You do it out of surety, not out of imagination or because he told you and she told you. No. You do it because you know that this is what Allah called shirk and what the Messenger called shirk. And if you do it like that, then it will be accepted from you as a worship. If you do tawheed because you know Allah said do this, or you avoided shirk because you know that Allah or His Messenger told you to avoid it, then you are worshipping Allah by your actions. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst those who listen and follow the best. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه. الحمد لله وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن نبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم تسليما. الله سبحانه وتعالى has warned us severely against shirk. الله سبحانه وتعالى says وَيَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ مَا لَا يَضُرُّهُمْ وَلَا يَنْفَعُهُمْ وَيَقُولُونَ هَؤُلَاءِ شُفَعَاؤُنَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ قُلْ أَتُنَبِّئُونَ اللَّهَ بِمَا لَا يَعْلَمُ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَلَا فِي الْأَرْضِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى عَمَّا يُشْرِكُونَ. الله سبحانه وتعالى says they worship others besides Allah. But since they are ignorant, they don't know the meaning of worship, they call it something else. وَيَقُولُونَ هَؤُلَاءِ شُفَعَاؤُنَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. Oh, we are not worshipping them. We are just only making them as means between us and Allah so that they carry our needs to Allah. They become means between us and Allah. And they think they are not worshipping them by this. While this is worship, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْ لِلَّهِ الشَّفَاعَةُ جَمِيعًا. Say to Allah belongs all the shafa'ah, all the all the forgiving and achieving whatever you want through means, there is no mean but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no mean to Allah but Himself. As Zainul Abideen, Ali ibn Hussein, radiallahu anhu, said in his dua, beautiful dua, he said, Oh Allah, I supplicate to you alone, for there is no means to you but you. لا وسيلة إليك إلا أنت. لا وسيلة إليك إلا أنت. There is no means between us and you, except you only. So if you choose someone else, no matter who he is, and make him a means between you and Allah, then you are treating him as Allah. Then you are worshipping him, whether you know it or not. And this is the point. That's why we have to learn. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replied on those people. He said, Are you informing Allah of something that He knows it does not exist, neither in heavens nor on earth? Allah knows that there is no such means. No angel in heavens, no angel can be a means between you and Allah. And on earth, no human, no creature on earth can be a means between you and Allah. Okay, and then Allah says, Subhanahu wa ta'ala, amma yushrikun. Glory be to Him for this action of shirk that they are doing. Allah called it shirk. So if you call it, I am seeking a means between me and Allah, and you are happy that this is not shirk, no. You cannot change the names and feel happy about it, no. You cannot commit fornication and call it something nice and say, well, I'm okay. As the non-Muslims do, they call fornication making love. Fornication is making hate between you and Allah. Fornication is making hate even between you and many people whom you have transgressed against their dignity in this life. How could it be making love? Similarly, when you commit shirk and you call this shirk chocolate, it doesn't become chocolate. It doesn't become good. Shirk is shirk. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it clear in this verse that whatever is worshipped is of this nature. It neither can prevent any harm from you, nor it can bring any benefit to you. وَيَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ مَا لَا يَضُرُّهُمْ وَلَا يَنْفَعُهُمْ. Everything that is worshipped, whether it's an angel, whether it's a prophet, whether it's a good human, whatever you call him, يعني saint or whatever you call him, they have this quality. They cannot ward off any evil from you, and they cannot benefit you. The only one who can benefit you is Allah. The only one who can ward off the evil from you is Allah. Therefore, no one deserves worship but Him, because He is the only one who can harm or benefit you in the true way. And just like, because He is the Creator, no creator but Him. اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا وعافنا وتب علينا واصلح لنا شأننا كله. Oh Allah, give us the knowledge of our religion, especially the knowledge of Tawheed and Aqeedah. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد وارض اللهم عن أصحاب محمد رضي الله عنهم أجمعين وأقم الصلاة.